Hey everybody, and welcome back to another eventful episode of Scooter Talk News. As always, I got an action-packed episode ready for y'all, and I can't wait to get into it. If you're new here, my name is Wyatt Brown, and I've been a scooter rider for about 12 years. I am exceedingly passionate about our sport, and I truly want to showcase it for our community and expand it to the outside world. Go ahead and hit that subscribe button down below, because this is just the beginning, and I hope to do some really big things. Now that that's been said, let's get right into the weekly report. The official World Skate Organization, along with a handful of prominently involved scooter names, released information via Instagram regarding a webinar to discuss their plan and what they want to do with our sport. I had the opportunity to sit in and listen to the webinar, and I learned that they're trying to take our professional competition riding to the next level. Their goal is to have a World Championships this year in Buenos Aires, Argentina, and also to eventually get scooters into the Olympic Games. Now, no matter where you stand on this topic, you can't deny the impact that it will make on our sport. I'm very intrigued to see how this all plays out, especially with the ISF claiming to be throwing the World Championships in Lake Havasu later this year. On to some more chill news. The Olay Best Line Contest is back and it is in full swing. So many submissions have already been presented and it's only been going on for 1 week. They have a list of different categories you can enter and there's 250 on the line per category. If you haven't yet, make sure you go over to Olay's Instagram to see how you can get involved. Budapest Street Jam went down in Hungary a few days ago and the man Fridolin Ewald came through and took the win. I didn't hear too much about this event, but it seemed to have a pretty good turnout, and the spot seemed pretty sick too. Glad to see events and street jams happening all over the world now that COVID has slowed its pace a bit. Shout out to anyone behind that event, and cheers to you, Frito. That front lip was fat. Now over here in the US, another jam went down this past week. This one was the annual Denver Street Jam. This year, none other than local Midwest killer, Stacy Warner, took home the dub. Stacy has been on fire ever since winning the Salt Lake Jam last year. Everybody's seen the throwdown at the jam, and it's just building up more hype for the Salt Lake City Jam going down this weekend. With events and sessions happening all the time, make sure you go online and get involved in one near you. Unfortunately, not too many riders moving around this week, so we're gonna skip roster check and get right into a jam-packed video part of the week segment. Starting off this week's segment, we got the North boys in their newest project titled So Quiet. North sent their whole European team to Barcelona for 7 days to get together with filmer Maxime Pissin. This is the 9 minutes and 51 seconds that they could come up with. North has recently picked up some of the most heavy hitters from around the world, and it goes to show in this video right here. Every clip had momentum and heat behind it, just like every single rider that's on this trip. It's exciting to see trip videos like this happening more and more again. Last weekend, Scooter Hut sent down Sean Williams and Waza to the Australian Championships down at Volo Park. They went down and did what they do best and captured the whole event perfectly. The hype and the level of riding was displayed so well, and it looked like everybody there really had a good time. It's very sick all the support all the riders and divisions receive in the competition scene down under. Events like this one right here will fuel competition riders for generations to come. Make sure you go check out the full thing on Scooter Hut's YouTube channel. This year during the Coalition competition, we saw for the very first time an all-girls team that got the chance to go out there and contend with the big dogs. Needless to say, the women's team went out to Guadalajara and absolutely smashed it. These girls really went out there and put on for a whole demographic of scooter riders. They should all be super proud of their hard work, because I know how many riders it can inspire out there, regardless of gender. Blunt Titano Machia is the story of the Blunt Europe crew in Greece, a country full of history. The Titano Machia is an old Greek mythological war that opposed the Titans, led by Cronos and the gods, whose leader was Zeus. This big war took place in Greece for 10 years and ended with the gods beating the Titans. During this trip to Greece, the whole Blunt team was divided into two separate teams, and they battled hard to redo history and see if the outcome would be the same. This project is divided in two parts in order to show everyone the intensity of the fight. Which team do you think will win? Zeus or Cronos? Riders Joel Ingold, Jack Churchward, Noah Kelly, Angus Varney, and Charlie Stamp sent out with filmer Cam Lawrence to get an edit done during their trip to Melbourne a couple weeks ago. These dudes obviously have such a good time together and can piece together an even better video that captures it all. Love the vibes coming from this crew, and I hope to see a lot more come from them in the future. The third coalition video has just dropped, and this time it's the team of Kai Saunders, Jonathan Peroni, Maxime Bouzid, Adrian Kingolo, and filmer Bradley Morrissey. This team of riders from mostly France went down to Guadalajara and put on a show. The level of riding and difficulty of some of these tricks were definitely next level. The boys did such a wonderful job, and they should be really proud about what they were able to come up with. Shout out to Bradley for taking home best filmer in the contest. This week's IG Top 5 section starts off with this monster 900 flare done by Corey Sponseller down at the Village in Australia. Corey blasts this flare combo and stamps his name on the very short list of the people that are able to do it. Congrats for smashing this one out, and I can't wait to see what comes for this rider for the rest of the year. Aaron, also known as Fool of Whips on Instagram, stays on a constant grind and is slowly creeping his way up the ranks. My mans make these combos look so smooth and can really link anything together. I mean, the front board 270 Manny all the way to the other ledge is just wild. Keep killing it out there, Aaron. New double flare combo just went down to concrete. Byron Mitchell, also out of Australia, stomps this huge double flare downhill on this fat concrete quarter. Byron has been putting down double flip and double flare combos for years now, but this one is particularly interesting. I just can't wrap my head around how you manage to catch a downhill while you're flipping your body twice. Oliver Seckel out of California just uploaded these floaty Insta clips, and I really can't get enough of them. Mans carry such speed and such style while linking together some really tough combos. I think Oliver is right on the verge of taking off here soon, so y'all need to keep your eyes peeled and remember the name. To finish off this week's segment, we got the bro Blake out of New York City. My dude has been on a mission lately, and he goes so hard in these clips. The three heel lip was so butter, and I can't wait to see what this dude can do once behind an actual filmer. Keep shredding out there, Blake, and let's see a real part sometime soon, my boy. Scooter Talk News episode 8 has officially come to an end. But don't worry, because I'll be right back here next week with plenty more exciting scooter news. Thanks to everyone who made it this far, and thanks to everyone who continues to come back and watch every week. It's always so refreshing to engage and interact between each other within our community. Till I see y'all again, peace out.